right? Next, let's go to the segment charts or divisional charts. That's what LRO now we call it, divisional charts. But the right word to use is the segment chart. Why do I use the word segment chart? Segment chart basically, it's like there are 12 dimensions of life, right? Now, each dimension, if you have to analyze in the Rashi chart, it will be very difficult because there's so much of noise of other things that are there. If you want to only analyze one such dimension, for example, the career, the marriage, the children, all these things, you look at the segment chart, it will filter away all the noises and only give you that aspect of it. But one word of caution, the segment chart has to be looked along with the Rashi chart. Lot of modern scholars keep telling you, don't look at the segment charts, don't look at the Rashi chart, just look at the segment chart alone. Don't do this. It has to be looked along with the Rashi charts. Now, I have given you the list of all the segment charts that are there. You don't have to look at all the segment charts every time. If you just look at four charts that I'm going to tell you, by and large, you will be able to make your predictions right. Which are the four charts? The first chart is the Rashi chart, the main chart. The second chart?
D9.
Dr. Vasan mentioned this. D9. The third chart?
D10.
Okay. Any other guesses? Bhava chart. Okay, good guess. Any other guesses? Varahamira recommends that we look at the Drekkanna. D3. So that's the next important chart. In fact, he is one of those guys who has detailedly explained Drekkanna in his Bruhat Jataka. So next chart that I always recommend you to do is the D chart. And then finally, from personal experience and also from the family's experience, I can tell you D30, which is Trimshamsha. This is a very important chart to look at. Why? Because it will also tell you what are the evils that are there. ನೀವು ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದರೆ ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಒಳ್ಳೇದಾಗತ್ತೆ ಒಳ್ಳೇದಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಒಂದೇ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ದು. ಹೀ ಆರ್ ಶಿ ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಸೊ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಸಮ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಸಮ್ ರೆಮಿಡಿಯಲ್ ಮೆಜರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಐ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಕಂಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿ ಟು ಮೈ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ GPS. Google Maps, what does it turn? Suddenly it will say, you are going in this route, there is a red color mark, traffic will be more, don't go in that direction. The moment you realize that, you can immediately take a detour and go to another chart. D30 chart gives you that red spots, like Google. It will clearly tell you, during this particular point of time, your dimension A will be troubled, dimension B will be troubled, etc. So look at that. Now, how do you study the divisional charts? Next question. ಇವಾಗ ತಾನೇ ಹೇಳದ್ನಲ್ಲ, ZAP. ಅಪ್ಲೈ ದ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ZAP, ದ ಝೋಡಿಯಾಕ್, ಅಸೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟ್. ಇನ್ ಅಡಿಷನ್ ಟು ದಟ್, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದಟ್ ಭಾವ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಕಾರಕ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೈವ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡಿವಿಷನಲ್ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎಂಪವರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಫರ್ಟಬಲಿ ಸೇ, ಓಕೆ ಔಟ್ಕಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ವರಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್. So this is how you need to look at divisional charts. First apply ZAP. Then next you have to analyze three important houses. What are the three important houses? You have to analyze the Lagna in the divisional chart. Then you have to analyze the Chandra Lagna in the divisional chart. And the corresponding house in the divisional chart. Once you do this, next analyze the Karaka. Now the rules to analyze each of these things I have given you in the previous ZAP. If you follow these principles, you will clearly know what tendencies are there, whether it is auspicious, whether it is inauspicious, what are the positive traits that you will get, what are the negative traits you will get, what type of environment you will face. So with this, let's go to the next one, which is T.